put in the plant materials into the oxlet, coarse plant material, Terminalia coriacei. Already kept the cotton where the siphon tube start into the oxlet. So small quantity, the coarse powder of the plant leaf, and adding into the oxlet main body tube. And I'm just giving the push by the glass rod so that the plant material will be, there should not be the gap, more gap, gap is required, but there should not be the more gap. This plant material is already dried properly. Sand. Again, I am giving push to the main body of oxlet. Little more plant material can be added till the bypass tube. After adding this plant materials, will keep it on a side, and the thimble which we are telling on the top, this cotton plug that will put at the surface of the plant materials is incorporated. This cotton will put by the help of glass rod, that so that the plant material should not go along with the solvent into the bypass tube, and they will keep the finishing here. Bit push is required so that the thimble will be completely packed into the cotton plug like that. We can, here also we have kept the cotton which is work as a filter, the solvent which will go inside the siphon tube. Now this we are going to keep into the assembly. This is the plant material. This is the round bottom flask where already we kept the, what you call that, porcelain dishes, we can see inside, which already we arranged in the stand, and this we are going to put. Before that we'll add petroleum jelly white that we are going to add into the oxlet so that it will be fixed there. This bottom up spreading this petroleum jelly. Now we are going to fix it into the assembly. Here is our half of the assembly which we have arranged properly. Now this is the time to pour the solvent from the top. This is the petroleum ether which we are going to add for the defat of the plant material. Here we are going to add petroleum ether slowly from the top of the soxhlet. That has to be very much carefully, because as we know, the petroleum ether is highly evaporable, volatile in nature, inflammable also. So this we are adding slowly, and which is getting immersed into the plant material. We are giving the time to run the solvent in between the plant material and a complete immersion. Again we are adding this solvent slowly. We can see the vapor is coming. Vapor, it is visible as it is volatile in nature. Slowly the soxhlet tube is filling. Simultaneously the siphon tube also should fill. So likewise, siphon tube is also going up whenever we are adding solvent from the top. Here we can see when the siphon tube will, the solvent will reach in siphon tube till the bent tube, the all solvent will go down to the round bottom flask. It's the capillary principle will work here. Slowly we are adding the solvent, and slowly we can see the level of solvent is increasing in the siphon tube as well as in the soxhlet body. And now it is going to reach at the point. Now we can see it has been reached, and now it is going to siphon. Slowly the solvent is going, and it is almost at the U-turn of the siphon. Here we can see solvent, still it required some more solvent to be added from the top. Now we can see it is siphoning. See the siphon, all the solvent, it is going down to the round bottom flask nicely without doing anything, and the solvent, the soxhlet body will be empty now, and the all solvent has reached to the round bottom flask. Now this is the time to put the condenser on the top. As we have kept the condenser on the top,
are making. That image is even.
This is the condenser.
This is tube, this is stand, this is...